This object in the middle is known as the 3D cursor. We can show and hide it like this. The 3D cursor is mostly used to move the selected mesh's origin. Do you see a dot in the middle of the cube? That's mesh's origin. If we were to rotate the mesh will use that origin as the pivot. We can move the origin to the 3D cursor like this. Another method is to move the mesh in edit mode, away from the origin like this. I'll show you Alt-H duplication method. What's the difference? Unlike Shift-D method, Alt-D creates an instance, meaning it will follow and use the original mesh's modification. The cube on the right was duplicated by using Shift-D. It's not affected by the original mesh's changes. Shift A is used to add a new object. Since we've activated the extra objects, we can add a complex mesh like this one to the scene easily. Let's learn about the loop cuts. Tab to go to edit mode, and Ctrl R to add a loop cut. Mouse wheel up or down will add or remove loop cut segments. In edit mode, 1 will switch to the vertex selection more, 2 for the edges, and 3 for the faces. Type 2, and Alt select an edge like this to select the edge loop. Shift Alt select works as well. Alt select an edge, and press G twice to edge slide. Let's add a subsurf modifier. The modifier smooths sharp meshes by adding more details along with scaling, and they can be sharpened up by using loop cuts. I, as in India, to extrude inward. E to extrude. That's how easy it is to model a complex mesh in Blender. I'll show you how to divide and combine viewports. Hover the cursor in this region until the cursor changes to a cross. Drag a new window like this. Numpad will change the views only on one side, and this setup can be used to model a new mesh really well. We can tell where the front side is, by typing tab to go to edit mode and selecting the visible face like this one the front viewport. By the way, I'm using the left mouse button to select an object, but we can always change that under preferences. F3 will search. Certain items are only available via searching, so F3 is very useful for quick enhancements like this. By the way, there's another way to subdivide. This object turns a cube into a sphere, but another subdivision will divide the mesh without changing its overall shape. In edit mode, A to select all, right click, and S to subdivide. We can change the smoothness setting to turn the mesh into a spherical mesh. In object mode, right click and S to shade smooth. This is the end of the first beginner tutorial. Thank you for watching.